about 4 o'clock. The campers both stopped in Woodward and got washed because they were absolutely disgusting. So after an hour delay there, so the combine and grain cart beat us home, but now we are bringing in all of the stuff out of the camper, so we have all of our food back in the house. So everything's quite a process moving from the trailer house into the house, and so it takes a lot of loads to get everything back in here, but that's what we're up to now. Today is October 25th, and we've got most of the stuff all out of the camper now, and so I am in the process of deep cleaning, get the vacuum out, got the fridge completely undone, and we're cleaning it, and so it's just kind of a process to get one thing done and then into the other. If you looked at my house right now, it's a disaster, but I've got everything out of the camper so I can get it clean, and then it'll be back into the house to organize. With the kids being the age they are, obviously they're still growing, so the clothes that are in their drawers and stuff now, since it's been about 4 or 5 months, those are not going to fit, and so we're gonna have to go through drawers and get all of that stuff taken care of, and so it's just kind of a long process, but in a few days we will be settled back into our house and all will be well. Today is October 27th, and I just pulled into the school parking lot for Riggin's first elementary game. He just started school yesterday, but they were already in basketball season, so he's gonna hop in and start playing today. So his game's actually about 3:45, so I just left the farm. I went over today and gathered some stragglers. Yesterday, Dylan and I went over together and fed everything and found some of them on their winter pastures, moved them back over, their summer pastures, and then moved them back over to their winter pastures so they're just easier to catch. And next week we'll start weaning those calves and we'll sort them off and all that type stuff. So we have kind of transitioned from harvest to ranch mode. Although Dylan left today for back up to North Dakota to get round two. So him and Dalton are gone. It'll take 2 days to get up there, and then they will load stuff, and then 2 days back. So he won't be back till early next week. And then we'll get back into the ranch mode of getting the mamas and babies sorted off so they can get weaned. And then we'll be preg checking next week after that. So stuff never stops. We just jump from harvest to ranch. So we'll just kind of get that going, and the work never stops. So that's kind of what's going on right now.
Hi guys, it's October 27th. I am here in my father-in-law Roger's field. I am just giving you an update on our corn harvest. This weekend, on Friday, I was supposed to be leaving early morning to go to my brother's rehearsal for his wedding, and we ended up not leaving till 2 because of harvest. So we ended up having to help Roger move because we picked up another job for a neighbor, so we had a bigger move. We had to move the equipment and all the semis and stuff over there. Ended up having to get another corn head ready and going because we took the corn head we were using up to Donnybrook so we could run 2 up there. So we had to get that all ready to roll since it was the first time for the year. So we ended up not leaving till 2. So got there pretty much just in time for rehearsal. Ended up just changing clothes and heading, so we were a little dirty, but everybody understood. Everybody understood our lifestyle, so it all worked out. So we got that guy done. We finished up our own corn yesterday. Donnybrook will be done probably tomorrow. Them 2 combines will be heading to Sterling to do about 1,000-acre job. And Rogers will be done probably tomorrow too. So our corn harvest is definitely coming to an end. But you never know when the end is, because we have picked up a few jobs that we were not planning, so can't ever say exactly when it's going to end, but it's ends coming near. Our corn around here has been running anywhere from 100 up to 180. So it's a variation, but it is a very good corn crop for around our area. So that is what we are up to right now. Harvest is end in sight. And yeah, that is what we're up to. Myself and Kimberly are off to a Carrie Underwood concert. So yes, we do get to enjoy ourselves every so often, but had to stop out of the field to make sure everything was in order before we headed out. But that is what we are doing right now. So I'll let you know when our corn harvest actually ends.
Today is October 28th and it is about dark. We've about worked all day. Levi and I have captured and sorted 4 pastures. So this is the sound of weaning. Some babies are missing their mamas. Today is October 29th, and me and the boys did some more gathering today. Got all of the pastures actually done today. So all the bulls are out. All the calves are sorted off. Mama's taken back to their pastures. And so tomorrow we will go through them and sort them, heifer and steer. So we're going to go ahead and take our steers to a sale on Tuesday. That's kind of one of the main reasons that we went ahead and did this while Dylan was gone, because there is a Red Angus sale that we wanted to take our babies to. So it will hopefully bring a little bit better, since we raise Red Angus and it is a specific Red Angus sale. So thought we would try and get that done, and hopefully that'll go good for us. We're actually going to just keep our heifers for a little while, feed them out, and then probably sell them in the spring. So the boys actually spent the night with their grandparents tonight. So I am just heating up some leftovers, and then I am going to shower and go to bed and not be sorry that it's only 7:10 right now. So I'm gonna get a good night's rest, and hopefully Dylan will be back tomorrow with round 2, and we will be done with harvest stuff and everything will be back home, and we can just kind of jump right on into the cattle stuff. Today is October 30th, and the boys and I sorted cattle today. We got up and went to church, and our church actually starts at 8:30, so we were done by 9:30 and back at the farm and started sorting. So we have around 175 head of calves, I would say. And first we sorted heifers from steers. Then we sorted reds from blacks. Then we sorted mine and Dylan's from Levi and Kitty's. And so we sorted literally all day long. Things went pretty well, I think, but had a few little hiccups here and there that we had to sort one out of the pen that got in where it shouldn't have been, but that always seems to happen. But other than that, it went pretty well. We got them all bedded down, fed hay and some feed, and we have a semi truck coming tomorrow to take our red heifers or our red steers to the El Reno sale, and then we'll just keep our heifers for a little while and feed those out, and then I think that's what we're planning on doing for now. And got anything to say, Reagan?
It was fun and dusty.
fun and dusty. Yes, we made sure we cleaned our ears after our shower for sure today. So that is what's going on today.
Headed to the sale barn.
Dylan, you guys do excellent work right here. You guys want to buy some of the best red eggs down here today? I would say that'd be a pretty good place to start at 160. Well, not at 160.
Today is November 1st, and Dylan and I just got home from El Reno. We went down and watched the cattle sell today. So we ended up doing things a little different this year. Usually we keep our cattle and feed them out and then sell them in the spring, but we usually have some wheat to graze them out also. But the last couple years we have not had that with the drought, so this year we made the decision to go ahead and just basically sell them right off the cow. We just weaned them and took them straight to town, so we don't have a lot of feed price in them. And we are very short on hay, so we just made that decision to just go ahead and get rid of our steers. And it ended up being actually a good decision. They brought really well today, so we were pleased with that. And so tomorrow we're going to go over and kind of mess with the heifers, and we've got 97 head of those still in the corral. We'll go over and sort on them tomorrow and kind of see what we have there. And we actually might just do the same with them. We might feed them out for about a month just to get them a little bit bigger, because they are probably a couple hundred pounds lighter than our steers were. So we'll probably try to feed them for at least 1 month, get them a little bit bigger, and then go ahead and sell them too. So we'll kind of see what happens and what we come up with tomorrow as we're looking through everything. But I think that's probably what's going to happen. So that is going on, what's going on today.
So we're just about done here in central South Dakota. I think we only have a couple of fields left. And we've had some really good yielding corn, so we've got a lot of guys in trucks that are trucking it. So I got promoted to combine. So this is what I've been doing all day.
That's awesome.
Central South Dakota, and we are actually fixing to finish up this morning. I think we've got 165 acres to do for this crew. The other crew has about 100, and we'll be done. We'll be done today, which is like an absolute record. It's been a lot of years since we got done by Halloween. We've had record weather this year. It's absolutely incredible. So anyway, I just thought I'd give you a view of the beautiful morning we have and the corn that we're cutting.
It's November the 5th, about 8 o'clock in the morning, and I think it's about 19 degrees right now. And this is what loading up and going home looks like. Our first round of equipment went home. So that was 3 combines and a cart. And so all we have today is a combine and a cart, some grain trailers, a truck that needs some help, and and our camper. So it's cold, we're tired, the equipment's tired, and we're going home. Day and a half later, this crew made it home. We've had the most amazing weather for a fall harvest that we've ever had. We'll probably never get this kind of weather again, but we had a great fall. We had great farmers, we had a great crew, and 2022 season's done.